Wow. Cyrus says Monday morning, and that's if you see it live. Hopefully, you'll watch it much later once you've cleaned it up. Strangely, this is 6 months of the show. 6 months. No, not live for 6 months, as in live every day, 5 days a week. But basically, we're on for 6 months, which is huge in today's day and age. Governments don't last that long. Look at Australia. Every 2 months, they turn around a government. But I've got an opening thing for Monday morning, which I'm going to stick to, which is English words penetrating the vision and minds of beautiful people like Amit and Silvery, who join us on the show. And I've got a word which I think, you know, I'm trying to find the right word. The word has to have more symbolic meaning as well as real meaning. So it's an adjective, and it's Bollocky.
Okay.
Bollocky. Bollocky is an adjective, and it's a very important word. You must know this. Arm yourself with this word. And even if you don't,
Yeah.
once you know it, you'll be able to, you know, you'll feel power wherever you go, because you can use this word to show off and to save
Okay.
yourself.
Dude, this is not of
Bit of
same
slang.
class. Yeah, no, it's also not of the same caliber as the earlier words you pulled up here. That those were hard. This is not like
You
of
think this is
having
not hard?
the something having the aspects of bollocks, right? It is bollock-like. It is
But look at your
ballsy.
thinking, your gutter thinking, Amit Doshi. I mean, you just
Yeah.
immediately went with bollocks. You sound like a parliamentarian in
What
England with a
does
bad
that
accent.
mean?
What the? This, I mean,
Bo
yeah,
you're
okay. So the
calling it
word
an
bollock
adjective,
is
it's
in bollock.
bollocksy, so it's like a bollock. It's like bollocks.
It's like saying the word fuck is in Fakhruddin, the name. I mean, there's no point to that.
No,
You know, there's no
it's
point.
not fuck and
Bollock
not
is there.
Fakhruddin.
Bollocky.
But if you say fucking or not
Fucky.
fucking like fuck
Okay, the word dick is in dicky
fuckery
bird. I mean, what's the
fuckery.
point?
When you say fuckery, that is the same as bollocky. Fuckery.
It's not the same. You're wasting my time. But go ahead and
Okay.
take a shot. Take a shot. Silver, you seem
Like,
to know more.
yeah, it's something you're not happy with. So it's like, ah, bollock. This thing is bollocky. Like, ah, bollocks. You know, I think it's a British term. I think it's a
no, I
British
think an
term.
adverb.
You're just again stuck on bollocks. I was expecting more from
Okay.
you guys. You've never used this word in common conversation when you're sitting with your friends having a drink. You've never, either of one of you, said the word bollocky. I'm appalled. I'm stunned
I
at
know,
this level of
man.
ignorance. I can't believe you
Deprived.
guys, English
Can't say
educated.
I
One
have.
of you went, Siri, you went to nine schools, nine bloody schools,
Yeah,
and nothing to show for it.
sure. Yeah, none of them taught
Bollocky.
me bollock. Yeah, I feel my
It's.
education was incomplete.
Are you ready to learn what it is?
I
Yes,
would
yes.
be very glad to be educated that I'm wrong.
It's an adjective, and it means the word naked. That's all you got to say is, you know, he's bollocky, as in he's naked. That's it. That's all there is to it.
That
It's
feels
just.
reductive. The word is richer than that. I'm sorry.
The word is not richer than that, because
It
right here
is,
I'm
man.
holding the bloody Oxford Dictionary 10th edition, the foremost authority on current English, the Indian edition, of course, so there's always controversy. But
Yes.
it's written very clearly, bollocky adjective or informal naked, as in informal in that, you know, the strange font, which
Okay.
means it's an informal usage of a
Right.
word. Okay, so guys, don't point fingers at me. You have problems, go straight to Oxford. And
I
you can
will
even
go to
ask about
Oxford.
The vaccine as well. Okay, since we're trying to get, that's another problem we're
Yeah.
having across the world right now. My son needs to go to Canada, and they've still not accepted AstraZeneca, Oxford Zeneca, whatever the hell you
Oh,
want to call
still
it.
not done.
Not done in Canada, bro. So now they said you go for 14 days wherever you want to, wander around a neutral country like Mexico, where you know you could land up doing drugs or things like that, or get, you know, into some
I
gang.
thought Canada was opening direct flights to India in the next couple of
Direct
days.
flights are there, direct flights from July 24th. But the problem is the student from India, this country which had COVID, is being targeted by many other countries. And unfortunately, right now, until Canada changes its way, he can't go. Hopefully, they will. But as of
Yeah.
now, like Germany changed its mind a week back, a few other countries, France has come around. So hopefully, because you don't land up going to Syria to study, you know.
Right.
Damascus is open, Damascus University, he's gotten there as well, but they've, you know, we're not going yet. They didn't ask for the certificates or anything. So
That's.
unfortunately, it's the same 10 countries where people go to study, and
But
that's where we spend.
I've been hearing people talk about that, right? Like, go to Mexico, spend 15 days over there, then go to the US.
You know, that's clearly one way. If you have the money
Yeah.
and someone to accompany you, because they're still minors, although they're 18. I mean, you've seen South Bombay boys. Can you leave
Yeah.
them alone in Mexico? They'll never
No.
come back. They'll be adopted by some family called the Alvarez and or whatever, and you know they'll be in a gang. And God, I mean, he'll be eating tortilla for breakfast.
Yeah,
Changed
that's the
completely.
problem.
So it is
Seriously,
bollocking
that's what
situation.
18-year-olds old are that's what 18-year-olds are going to do in Mexico, right?
But wait,
That's the
my son, very sensitive young man, actually gave me a list of countries. almost like he was going on a travel tour. Why don't I go to Egypt? He said. I said, I'll tell you why you're not going to Egypt. Because it costs money for 14 days. That's why you don't go fucking Egypt. You know? He's looking at it like travel advisory. I think Egypt will be good for 14 days. You know, check out the
mummies. I think Dubai will be nice. In Dubai,
you know how much Dubai costs for 14 days, brother? There's no poverty in Dubai. There's no place to send him. Yeah, either you know you're working like a chauffeur and sadly in bad conditions, or everything else is 5-star. So you're screwed. 14 days is a long time. That and he's stuck, true. Remember, in that hotel room, you have to pay for everything, blah, blah, blah.
And probably the burj, because Dubai, right? There will be
he'll ask for
burj.
It. But boy, he'll ask
yeah,
for
exactly.
He, never, he doesn't look at the right side of the menu. He doesn't have the lower middle class philosophy of his father. You see, this is the problem with each generation. They keep thinking that they were born rich. We know we weren't, you know. So we always look at the right side of the menu. It's sad. Of course, in Dubai, it's the left side of the menu. It's Arabic, yeah?
Uh-huh. Oh,
wow. Okay, so Bollocky, you failed again. Guys, tell me one Monday you're going to get this right. Okay, let's see how many
I
Mondays
got it possible. Right. I didn't get last week, right? No. Because last week, you just made some shit up. The week before, I got right.
No, you didn't. I can't remember any words, so forget
even
it.
I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure I got the first
I can only remember
right.
Farts. I can only remember farts.
Yeah, I got farts, right?
No. Amit, why would I lie? We can play the link. You were all over the place. It was an embarrassment. Where to edit it? I haven't okay. seen you like so awkward. Really, it was like Spanish. I mean, you didn't know what you were saying. You'd gone berserk. Really. Are you on AstraZeneca?
Word, I remember dose. Saying that it was a Yiddish word.
Hey, one sec. Aren't you going back to America?
I am.
So, are they allowing you in with the double COVID?
US
COVID shield, rather?
US passport.
Oh, that's good enough.
That's good enough.
Then they give you the vaccine as you enter.
Well, no, I don't vaccine. Need to. No, but I'm fine with this. My mom is gone and she's got.
You're fine. Do they accept it?
Yeah, my mom is in the US right now with double dose COVID AstraZeneca. Come and here. She's out in the world. Yeah.
And they let from the airport, there's no problem. Straight away,
there's
you know.
She... Nothing.
Oh, very interesting. Let me see because I have the freeloading can be done in America. We have relatives and friends there.
No, it cannot because they are not accepting Indian citizens into America.
Oh, why? Right, what's wrong with us?
So
is
right
it
now,
hello.
So as a US citizen, I can go back.
For an Indian person,
you have to basically they for anybody who's a non-US citizen, you have to have spent 14 days outside.
Bashing. While you're quietly an American citizen, you do the Indian government bashing and leave me and Sandy
to face the
attack. I don't
bash the Indian government.
We don't have a second country to go to.
I thought I'm the right winger on this show.
Yeah, well, yeah. When it comes to tech and NBA, you're right winger, that's for sure. Is there a pun in that? Because I don't know if they have a right wing in basketball. I'm not football and rugby. Well, do. Yeah.
So they have wing players, but it's not really a right or left wing because everybody
it's the same thing.
Any
field sport, the guy who plays on the flank is a wing player, right?
Is a wing.
So you'll
player,
have a right.
Yes. But you don't have a right and left wing, right? Because the play everybody moves around a lot, right? The entire court, everybody.
When you're
plays,
shooting,
so,
your right wing shooting there and left wing shooting there. God, it sounds like India. No, your right wing shooting there.
No, because a wing player is not necessarily also a shooter. A wing player is somebody who attacks the basket. It's basically a forward.
They don't
a small
play positions
forward.
In basketball like they do in football.
They do.
You don't
they
mark
do,
your position. That's your position.
It's not that tight. You play.
It's good.
So today the current thinking is positionless basketball is the best way to play. But at this, having said that, there are positions. But the positions are center, which is the guy in the middle, the tall guy. Power forward, who is the big guy with like, you know, ability to rebound and score some points. Small forward, who is the wing. Shooting guard, who is the other wing, right? And then point guard, who is the guy who distributes the ball, who basically dribbles the most and throws the ball and basically passes the ball the most.
My God. And they're locked right now, aren't they? Milwaukee and Phoenix?
Yes, they are. Well, no, Milwaukee went up yesterday, 3-2.
Okay, but it's still a bit of a dogfight, right?
It's a good series. That game yesterday was amazing. It was an incredible game yesterday.
Let's close on Silvery's features. I want to see his reaction to everything. all things basketball.
Yeah.
Actually, you know, we did that show with those three kids. They were great, by the way. What was the show called? New Kids on the Block.
New Kids on the Block.
And he found his kindred spirits in the two girls when me and the young guy, what was his name?
Trivik. You and Trivik.
Trivik and I were discussing Liverpool. And so the three of them bonded, you know, as non-sport people who are irritated with the arrogance of the sports lovers in the room who continue talking like you don't exist and go on, you know, in your presence. Yeah, so he found that kindred spirit with the two girls. And what is the action? The action is already famous.
Just go on. Move on. Finish it. Yeah.
Let's go.
It was a very fun episode, though.
Yeah. No, it was good. Last week was good. Even the William Dalra thing was good.
Oh, but that was not shot that day.
Okay. I think that most people know that.
I don't know. Yeah. I think he's okay in Delhi, but he'll have to be careful in some states in India. His views are very clearly belong to another government. Let's put it that way. Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Wow. Well, while we're talking, the yatras have been sort of cancelled. They've taken Jagannath yatra, this and the other. Yeah. They're backpedaling a little bit. It's not clear. I'm trying to get this filter the news that's coming through. But for example, Uttarakhand and Himachal and all these places are saying no to tourism. And so at least they're making some feeble attempt. Let's see what really happens.
They are. Let's see. I mean, we're so close. Just wait till it's over, right? I mean, like, it's just so close now.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the comedy here, which nobody seems to get, is like Himachal says in Shimla, they'll put a ceiling to the tourists, right? Now, how does that really work? This great maths puzzle that people come up with. Is 68 people in a room? I just did a Sangeet in Calcutta, so I shouldn't really be talking. But who's to decide the figure? That boggles my mind. This figure, how do you correlate it correctly? You know, 72 can come into Shimla, 49 can't. I don't know. How do you do that?
Yeah, but it is arbitrary. Of course, it's arbitrary. All of these, but by definition, everything like this has to be arbitrary, right? I mean, like,
in which case. It's a lottery anyway. That's all I'm saying.
No, but so I mean, like, so you're saying that
because you want some standards. I get what you're saying. You're saying, give me some perimeter, give me something, measure. So I'm giving a mathematical measure. 75 is my cutoff. But there is really no difference between 75 and 65 or 85.
There is no difference between 75 and 65 or 75 and 85, but there is a difference between 65 and 85, is there not?
Not really. It starts becoming
Is there a difference between 50 and 100?
Perhaps, depending on the size of the room, for example. There's another debatable point. Again, it's maths. It's all in relation, the theory of relativity. How big is the room? How many people? Where do they stand? It's not just cut and dry of 80 people.
Nothing is cut and dry. This is my thinking around this stuff right now at this point in time, right? I meet people. I'm not meeting people. Again, I'm double vaccinated, so I should meet people. I'd be stupid not to, right? So I do meet people. But at the same time, I'm not really keen on going into huge parties or anything like that at this point in time. I'm okay waiting on that stuff.
I just avoided prostitutes for the last 6 months. That's one thing I've not gone to. Or I myself put myself out there because times are difficult and one has to earn. But other than that, there's no physicality involved. I think for 5-10 minutes, you can meet anyone, hopefully.
Yeah, exactly. Get on with
it. Don't linger for hours and, sing a duet. That's probably difficult.
I've met people all the time, right? I mean, I think I've been meeting people
Were you bollocky at the time of meeting them?
Well, I was bollocky by my definition, not by yours, which was incorrect. Even if it might be the dictionary.
Of India. You're making your own stories up as you speak. You cannot have a level of bollocky. Bollocky clearly says in this beautiful book is naked and it's an adjective. There's no two ways about it. You can't say level of bollocky. My bollocky is different from your bollocky. Your bollocky is a higher level of bollocky.
Yes, because your bollocky is a subset of my bollocky. And my bollocky
I refuse to bow down to your bollocky. How dare you, you fascist leader. And I mean you, nobody else. Okay. What's your name again?
It's a name.
So over the weekend, I got multiple messages on Instagram from fans asking us to share some travel stories. So.
Oh, really?
Just putting it out there. Yeah.
Okay.
So I just come back from Kolkata.
Yeah, just go.
How was your travel?
So it's very interesting. As we were boarding the plane in Mumbai, this young lady with her 5-year-old irritating child, I shouldn't say that because I've had 2 irritating childs on planes myself, but you know how the noise level just changes with one kid going, "Hey, plane, I will leave." Some screaming in the background and whatever, but she's just a kid. And then suddenly they come up to her and say that we don't have that RT-PCR test, you can't board the plane. Which I found, and then there was huge drama that played out for 5 minutes. But I felt a little bad for the passengers because it's not always very clear. Each city has its own rules. Now, in Cal, I could show my double vaccine cert, which I have in the phone, with a picture of our leader, Namsucha. So that was good enough for them. But it wasn't good enough for Mumbai. Mumbai, we had to do the RT-PCR. So hardly 2 days in Cal, somebody had to come and, do a test for us, blah, blah, blah. Which is a real headache.
Isn't that the rule for any kind of flying?
No. So it depends. Now in Chandigarh, if you're going Chandigarh, Bombay, I can just show the double vaccine thing. If I'm going to Goa, I don't even know if you show anything. Each state has got their own thing. It's not clear. So the passengers can be victimized. You've got to really be paying attention all the time because the travel agent doesn't tell you. You know, it depends on how.
That's actually kind of silly. I mean, like, I think that there should be a nationwide, there should be a national kind of policy.
Why can't we have a holistic, one uniform, homogeneous sort of
whether
thing, you know?
It is double vaccine, whether it's RT-PCR. If you need RT-PCR, you need RT-PCR. Then make everybody do RT-PCR.
Absolutely.
That's it.
Be clear, because you're with kids and all that. I feel really bad for that family, you know. Suddenly, last minute, what are you going to do? You know, and then what are you going to do? Because they don't give you the test option now because it's in another area of the airport.
Yeah.
So they've missed the flight if they go to their other area of the airport. It's a good 20 minutes walk, etc., and then line to the max.
But you can get the test done at the airport itself. What?
So they could, but now they move the where it was just close to where you know
but
when you deplane.
Doesn't the test take like 3 hours to kind of get a result back? I thought like the chemistry took 3 hours.
They can trace you after that if they allow you to go on. No, you're then on the list. So these options are there.
But then what about all the people you infected on the plane?
Correct. So then let's have one rule once and for all. That's all we're saying. Yeah. And what is the point of this double COVID cert thing, you know, if they don't accept it? And Mumbai is the city which is being most belligerent about all this. Which is making me think, who do I vote for? I'm really all over the place with this one. Then, of course, Sharad Pawar just met Modi in a tete-a-tete. What's going on there? I mean, I wonder. You think? I mean, that would be just...
All things are possible.
Uddhav Thackeray is fast asleep. He wakes up in the morning. There's no government.
Listen, after what happened after the Maharashtra elections last time, all things are possible. Basically, now any combination of four is possible at this point in time.
I think I'd hate being a politician. Exactly. When you start talking to the enemy or the so-called non-alliance partner, I mean, the alliance partners, it's just like when you start flirting with some other girl, you know, at a party or whatever, and then it starts becoming deeper. You can see texts on the phone or you're meeting them here and there and people see you at breakfast or lunch or whatever. I think for the person who's in the relationship, it's horrible. Imagine, because he's biting his nails thinking, I'm hanging by a thread here on top of everything else. Yeah, I've got COVID. He's inherited the worst karma, bichara. It's
interesting. It really is interesting because you really are kind of in that kind of like this. It really is relationship like uncertainty, right? What's happening right now? Do I know? Do I not know? Is there anything going on? Is there not going on? Really.
We didn't realize that politicians are as insecure as any one of us. It's just the human factor involved with being insecure. If you look at Amarinder Singh and Navjot Singh Sidhu in Punjab, you know, I mean, Navjot Singh Sidhu goes and plays a game of chess.
What's going on there, man?
I mean, again, I don't criticize the Gandhi family because there's Parsi blood there, but I'm really irritated. Sidhu goes there. Amarinder is the boss of Punjab. He's given you the state. He still runs it with an iron fist during COVID, etc. And then you go and empower Navjot Singh Sidhu, who's causing anarchy in a sense by going back and putting him in a place above the chief minister by making him the Congress president chief. So in a sense, he's above him in certain matters, you know, which is endorsing him and causing. But it's like divide and rule from the British perspective. You know, almost I've got two power sources now. I don't think that's going to work well. They need strong power sources in each state for them to come back. Strongly, it's not divided because they lose at the next round. You know, if you divide the power.
I don't understand this at all. Right? It's just like it's the definition of like just being dumb.
Yeah, it's a bit bollocky. No, that's a wrong word.
No, it's my bollocky, not yours. My bollocky, not yours.
I'm willing to call Rahul Gandhi. I mean, he's got relatives in Khushru Bagh. Let's have a tete-a-tete. Let's have a chat. I don't like this kind of leadership. I honestly don't understand. Because you're feeding the flames, you know. You're encouraging the fire to grow. Why?
No, but is it leadership? It's not, right? It's the very opposite in many ways. I don't get it.
It
makes no sense, right? Why you have somebody who is running your space over there for you to kind of go in and just like, you know, I mean, like for no reason whatsoever to like, you know, just undercut him. It makes no sense.
Sidhu, as much as we love him as a cricketer and, you know, I've toured with him and, you know, he's great fun and all that. He's always clearly looking out for himself. This will be his fourth party move if he moved to AAP, if he didn't get this chieftainship. He was on his way to AAP. He's already talking to them. I mean, it's just... Okay, I don't mind that because then you can understand the politicians watching it for me. Forget about this patriotism and all that. Just watching it for me. I jump party to next party to next party. Why? Because it's not for me. You know, you got to salute the BJP there because you know you drop people like Ravi Shankar Prasad and Javadekar. These are legends in the BJP. You've dropped them and there's not a word from them. they've accepted the rank and file situation and go back to the blocks and start all over again.
Well, because again, the, you know, I mean, like I think Veer Sangvi is really on point on politics and stuff like that, right? And he had written something about the high command and, like, you know, the infrastructure around high command and how that works.
Their corporate structuring.
Yeah, and so basically he was basically paralleling out how the Congress high command is no longer really a high command, because for a high command to work, you need to be able to win elections, which they're not being able to do. But the BJP high command has become a high command now. It is no longer the same kind of this.
Even more because of their success is what you're saying.
Yes.
Success breeds more power.
Even though they lost in Bengal and Chennai, Tamil Nadu, etc. But still, the Modi and Shah kind of
haven't gone
at
anywhere.
The top. Yeah, that, and I mean, like, there is popularity and power. There's popularity over there as well, right? Modi is still incredibly popular.
I would make Amarinder the Congress chief, firstly. You know, the president, rather, of the party, internal party itself. Because they need someone else to run it.
That's a whole different thing, right? Because
he's won you. He's a chief minister who's holding exactly your point. He's got it. He's paid the bills. You know, he's got that position and stature at the moment. So let him be the president. You know, because he's holding Punjab. And so he's got some sort of, you know, credibility. The point is, the credibility has been lost by the family and a few of the cohorts around. So you have to go with somebody else. If it was an MNC, what would have happened? Just tell me honestly. Any MNC in the world, any corporation in the world. The
company would have gone bust by now. Honestly, then, no jokes. If Congress was a company, Congress would be bust. There's no way that Congress is able to kind of...
It would be like a sick company, and it would be bought over, and, you know, probably by some small company like the Parsi Sena or some, you know, regional belt party, which feels bad for them, and then from there they regrow and restart. Perestroika.
It's poorly run. There are no kind of, like, who's there right now in the Congress outside of Rahul Gandhi, Priyanka Gandhi, and who's there? Who's left?
Yeah, well, his closest confidant is now civil aviation minister. That alone was a huge blow. Left, and now he's grown in the party, so there's no question of coming back, and he may take a few more from that younger brigade with him.
That would be you need opposition parties. You need somebody to provide a credible kind of alternate view, and it's just not there.
So, because they're not doing anything, they're like in a coma. But this thing that Amrit Sidhu is, you know, just this is why the pandemic in Congress continues. They need to do something. You got to accept where it's like how they talk about drug problems and say, you know, you got to first say you're a druggie. I tell everybody in my building, first say you're a druggie, even though you're not a druggie, because I just don't like them. But that aside, coming back to the point, you know, you got to admit where you are. They're not admitting where they are. Admit that you've lost two back-to-back biggies, 14-19, back-to-back biggies, plenty of state elections. You lost the seat of Amethi, which you should have walked. Like with your doggy in your hand, you should just walk twice around the courtyard and everyone voted for you in the old days. You lost that. Now, look inwards and say, man, we got to do something. If you really want to see change, how can they just expect it all like karma to happen, or, you know, the change in the weather, and then it's not going to happen like that. Although this COVID and all that may not help the BJP in the long run, we don't know yet. But honestly, if they don't do anything and try and recreate and reinvest, I don't see any point in having the party.
What are the alternatives today, right? If you and it's also really kind of this, so the ultimate, right, I mean, like, you know, the optimal kind of situation for our where we're going as governments, right, is we're a parliamentary democracy. We are not a presidential system.
No,
right?
We are a multiple party system, and that's where we're going,
and we need to kind of lean into that. Right. I mean, like, you know, the thing is that what's happened is, and this is a media fault to a great extent, even what we're doing right now. Why are we discussing Congress versus BJP as if it's a binary? It's not a binary.
It's not a binary anymore.
Yeah, it's not. And I think that by creating it and by treating it as a binary, kind of, is Congress or BJP, we're kind of minimizing the impact that other political parties can have. Right. And I think that's the problem.
Yeah. The regional parties will have to reach out a little bit, you know, the Mamtas and the, you know, as you go down to Tamil Nadu and Telangana and Andhra, all the big parties there will be playing a part. I don't doubt it.
It's not even parties which are regional in nature, right? Like, AAP is not a party which is regional in nature. It's regional in power structure right now, right? It's a Delhi, it's a North India party, but it's not a regional party.
He's trying to go in Goa, Punjab, slowly here and there, no doubt.
Yeah. And you need more of this kind of stuff.
His problem is that he has that terrible cap, which is not working for him. I think that that has to go. And the muffler, which was working for him, has to come back. Because people really took to that.
Yeah.
These little things make a difference.
A little more science friendliness would also not be a bad thing. A little more economic friendliness would not be a bad thing. A little more economic education would not be a bad thing. A little more pie in the sky.
He took the Delhi budget, amazing. And he did things with the Delhi municipal budget.
Yeah.
All right. He tried to, with sanitation, water, education, infrastructure, roads, parking, pollution. He's tried. Okay, now you can say he didn't do well enough, but he's tried.
It's not just that. Some of the concepts, some of the ideas were like just like, you know, economically.
The odd even rule wasn't great.
There's some weird stuff there.
Yeah. Again, now you guys are, you know, one second. Let's be devil's advocate for a second. What do you want to do? You guys are all visitors to Delhi. All of us go to Delhi all the time. What do they do? So they look towards Greece and other countries who came up with these ideas where, you know, how do you, it's a question again of maths. How do I balance the formula? So, okay, I'll take these people out and put these people in. We get half the cars on a daily basis. And people will learn to, they have a metro that's supposed to function. Unlike our metro, which was supposed to be ready last year, which I've just been told needs 6 months more. And that will go on for the next 3 to 5 years of 6 months more. So, you know, I mean, this idea was in the right place. Now, the implementation of every idea sometimes doesn't work. It didn't synchronize correctly.
Some ideas were right, some ideas were wrong.
The odd even rule sounds silly, but it gave them respite. You know,
some ideas were great, some ideas were not.
They had this good scheme with electricity, right? They were doing like some like reduced prices for electricity or like some amount of free electricity units.
Free electricity to a lot of chapters and areas of, you know, with a less fortunate live in Delhi. They love him. That's why he won the election again. You know, I mean, he did do education. Education, they love him because he's made education parallel. You know, we in India, we always have these two, the rich elite education and the so-called public welfare education. And it's not close to each other by any standard. In Delhi, it's now become very close to each other. And, you know, kind of organize holidays for the public welfare scheme schools to go to interesting places like Shimla, etc. and beyond, which, you know, they dream of. Suddenly, you know, your St. Columbus and your modern and all is not that far away from the guy who works for you in a uniform, his kid's school. So I've got a little time for him. I just think the cap should go. He should have one of those African-American things backwards, you know, a little more rapper. Yeah, dreadlocks. Lose the glasses. Maybe chew paan. So modernize yourself for India also. You localize the modernization. I think and the coughing. See, that was so much character was there, you know. Think of it in terms of political speak also. You're buying time in a conversation by, you know, somebody asks you a question at a PC and the question is like, what are you going to do about the state of aviation in Delhi? You know, which only I would ask because that doesn't concern the poor. Sorry about that. But, you know, then he can just cough for a few minutes while he thinks about the answer. Boom. So, and he's pushing for Punjab. He is pushing for Punjab. I'm not sure he'll make it yet. He's pushing for Goa. For some reason, these are the two states he's really after. And when you think about it, one is the state of prosperity. One is the state of pleasure. So I think it makes a lot of sense. You know, you make money in one place and you party in the other. So these are the two states a lot of people would choose. What do you say, Amit? It does make sense.
No, I think I think it has to do with who they have on ground over those at these places, right? I think that's probably a big part of it. Also, I think Punjab makes sense. It's right next to Delhi, is where the power structure is, right? Goa is a little more kind of this, but I think they have some good people in Goa, if I'm not mistaken, right? I mean, like when the India Against Corruption thing happened, some good people joined Goa.
And they believe the younger brigade there will be a sea change in Goa, it'll come to them. You know, at the moment, the older brigade is running the state and BJP still... But BJP is hanging on by this 10... It's not like a clear mandate anymore. So let's see.
We're going to see a lot of changes in the world, right? I mean, like, or a lot of changes in India, especially. Like, UP is going to be really interesting right now, right? Because, I mean, like, the Yogi is getting undercut all over the place by, like, you know, his quote-unquote supporters. It's going to be really interesting what happens there.
He reminds me a bit of, slightly worse dressed Kim Jong-un, because there are absurd statistics and comments coming out.
Oh my God. Do you want to hear the absurd Kim Jong-un stuff, right? I mean, like,
please.
So
my favorite, all time favorite.
There is a I'm talking about Yogi and the absurdist Kim Jong-un.
Either way,
have you guys checked out the new documentary? Have you checked out the new documentary on Netflix, How to Be a Tyrant? It's
I've
really
seen two of them so far. I haven't seen, I saw the Hitler and the Saddam Hussein ones.
What do you think is done? What do you think of how the documentary is done?
I honestly, I don't love the tonality of it. I like the information of it, but yeah, I don't love the tonality of it. I feel like...
So you've decided that you want to become a dictator. Yeah. This is what you have to do. Again, it's the playbook for you. And it's everything.
Don't we have that on Republic TV?
It's kind of like that. Yes, it's kind of like that. But it's again, it's Peter Dinklage's sound voice, right? I mean, like he's the narrator. So I think it kind of works in that sense. But I also I would have preferred a little more classic documentary style. Yeah. Kind
you want your gravitas in your series.
It's really interesting, right? What they're talking about is they're talking about, like, you know, what are the different paths to power that are common and what's the playbook that dictators use to get this stuff.
But if they're doing it with a wink, I think I'm going to check it out.
No, I think you'll enjoy it.
The world you're living in.
I'm not saying I'm not enjoying it.
Dictator?
Yeah. I'm enjoying it. I'm absolutely enjoying it. I wish it was a little more classic style. I think that's like my one kind of...
There's an oxymoron. Who's your favorite dictator?
Interesting question. Favorite dictator? Who?
Is the great Russian himself, Stalin. I tell you, Stalin is not given enough credit for his evil, his brutality, the ferocity in which he killed so many more people than the Germans.
Yes.
Hitler was nothing compared to the figures that Stalin has.
Are we going as in like...
Why do you underappreciate Stalin's evil?
When we're talking about our favorite dictators, are we going at maximum evil or are we going at maximum benevolence? Because I was actually thinking in the maximum benevolence style.
No. That's evil? A paradox which I can't get my head around. You can't slaughter 6 million people and save 3 children in a river or something. Being human concept, is it?
I was thinking of the Singapore dictator, right? I mean, like Lee Won Kwan. No,
but he's... That's... Oh, he's a...
No,
a
he's... Yeah, exactly. He's
him. A hugely interesting, enterprising personality who single-handedly put an island state together against these people who just brutalized and killed women, children.
Dictator, no? I think, essentially. Yeah. Essentially dictator.
But, yeah, okay. I get your point now. So in that sense, but that works only for a place like that. I mean, it's almost... Yeah. How many more examples will we have? 3 or 4, we really search.
Taiwan, right? I mean, like, Taiwan became democratic fairly quickly, but I mean, like, it was initially Mao Zedong's... There's the evil man, Mao Zedong.
Beautiful man.
Yeah. But his competitor at the time, who basically broke off Taiwan, right? That guy was running it for a bit.
Yeah, we haven't gone into Cambodia. Sorry?
Gaddafi's story is very interesting. And, like, the whole... His life also and the way he was assassinated also is this extremely... Interesting and fascinating. Bodyguards. I mean, brutal as hell, but
women
bodyguards, correct. Yeah, yeah.
This is a guy I appreciate that in all that he's still thinking sex. You know what I mean? Yeah, you're destroying people. All that. What the hell? You still want a chick walking around with a knife? You know what I mean? What the hell? You got to salute those guys. How did they become leaders?
There are some funny dictator names too, though, right? The Yugoslavian dictator Tito. Then the Cambodian dictator.
It was his last name,
Tito, I think. Then the Cambodian dictator, Pol Pot.
Tito, Pol Pot. Tito will be even funnier. Yeah.
Then
I have one. We have a dictator in the Skylark Cooperative Society, but not reached the levels of Stalin or Pol Pot. No, let's not name names. Who knows? Okay. This may be a very less watched podcast, but then with our bad luck, that's the only one they did watch.
Well, you've named Mr. Sharma like 25 times before on this podcast.
Mr. Sharma is just a name.
Exactly, which is why I called him Mr. Sharma.
But I gotta be careful. My dad is not well anymore to protect me legally.
Sorry, should we take a break? I think.
Guys, what's wrong with you all? Talk so much. Yes. The guests are so much nicer. You know, they're soft, simple. Those 3 kids were too much, though. They wouldn't stop talking. I could have just left. You and I could have just walked out, had a cigarette in the old days, come back, and they'd still be going on about something. That was fun. So here's our break. And here's our break over.
Yes.
I was telling you about the yogi stuff, right? I mean, like some of the there's this really interesting Twitter guy on Twitter named Karthik. He's like, I think the ex brand manager or like ex head of CMO for Flipkart or something like that. His Twitter is called Beast of Prague.
That would be a story.
Huh?
No, so his Twitter is called... Why is he ex?
How? Flipkart's been around for 20 years. They have many X now.
He's moved on, right? In a positive light.
Yeah, yeah. He's doing his own consulting and stuff like that. He's been on a couple of our shows at different times as well. His name is Beast of Trial or Karthik. I can't remember his last name right now. But he collects all this, and I just came across this weekend, right? He collects ads for Yogi, which are done, right? And what was amazing was that last week...
Sorry, you mean collect ads, as in?
So no, the ads Yogi, that are made by Yogi team.
By Yogi team, right? And basically kind of created as like these kinds of... They look like newspaper articles. It's branded content, right? Oh. All of the newspapers do this kind of stuff. And how it's not just in UP... This stuff is being sent across the country, right?
He's eyeing the chair.
He is very much eyeing the chair. Like, I don't think there is any question about the fact that he's eyeing the chair.
It gets more bold without, this is like alcohol, right? This power thing. You get more bold without knowing it. You suddenly, you know, start doing things where before you're paying obeisance to Narendra Modi and all that. Slowly, slowly, you know, you without knowing it, the chasm widens. You know, over a period of time, it's much wider, but it every day it widens a bit.
When I was looking at this tweet that he sent out, right, it was crazy to me, right? I mean, like, it's like he's got ads in Tamil Nadu and Bangalore and Kerala and Maharashtra and Gujarat and everywhere. And it's all looking as if, like, you know, I think this was either an HD or a Times of India piece. It all looked like it was an article.
For a Machiavellian Chanakyan figure, why did he get Bengal wrong and spoke in Hindi there? You know, I mean, if he was so smart to communicate correctly to the right people about the right issues, he went there and spoke of vegetarianism to Bengalis in Hindi. I mean, they rejected him immediately. Like, you know, everything you've done is wrong. Not to mention the outfit. Yeah. Okay, it was like, Bengalis like to dress up. What the hell is that? Have you seen a badly dressed Bengali?
Yeah. What the hell? I hope he goes to Gujarat and start talking about chicken and mutton and all.
Gujarat he'll never go to. He may not come back. Yeah. Look at us plotting our own little political vendetta. Yeah. Yeah. But the uneasy bears the head that holds the crown or whatever the line is. And I don't think you can get away from that. There's always the internal. There will be. We may not know it correctly, but there has to be an internal path that's brewing, a plot that's brewing.
Oh, no, 100% there's something going on, right? There's no question that there's something going on over here.
And Amit, you can't blame him. Again, it's sycophancy of our people and people across the world in power. The sycophants, the chamchas and chelas can't stop saying, boss, you should be in power. Boss, you should run the country. But, you know, they start saying this, they start believing it. Yeah. I used to get this. My mom used to keep saying I'm very good looking. So when I went to college, I thought all the girls would fall for me. You're really good looking, a good looking boy and all that. And I got nothing. 5 years of nothing, only the stray dogs. And even them, some of them would come. Some would be like, oh, yeah, not today. Yeah, too much petting. So I'm just saying, you know, you start believing your own myth. That's horrible. But this, again, not to mention Nazi Germany, but this propaganda and taking it seriously has always been very strong from 14 onwards. Okay, which was not so strong in Indian diaspora, Indian.
I would disagree with that. I think that we
give
have been
examples?
A propagandist.
Give me examples. So,
when
in the Rajiv Gandhi, Indira Gandhi era, there was not so much push. There was control. So there was control is different from push.
But because there was not so much media, right? I mean, like, if you look at what happened during the emergency and such at that point in time, right? There were people who stood up, but they all went to fucking jail.
But you're trying to control. Control is different from pushing. See, this is a propaganda. Propaganda is like, by the way, I'm just suggesting this to you, but I'm suggesting it every day so it goes in your head.
Okay, I will give you propaganda right now, okay? I will probably get trolled like fuck for saying that this is propaganda, but you cannot tell me that this does not fit the definition of propaganda. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. That is propaganda.
One slogan that's upset you for 40 years.
Garibi Hatao. That is propaganda.
Philosophically not wrong. I mean, the idea of removing poverty.
No, but again, the when you're talking about, okay, let's go Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, right? The fetishization of the army and the farmer has been a tremendously destructive force for this country. You must admire army people. You must admire farmers for the work that they do. But this kind of this idea that they are above the rest of us has been tremendously destructive for us as a country, I think.
Not only above the rest of us, but are almost godlike. You know, another position to the Indian citizen. Yeah. Right. Which is wrong, because how the hell? You must be allowed to abuse every community in India. This is the only way secularism will you know, thrive.
I agree. No, and also, I mean, like, you know, we want to move people off farming, right? Farming is not a good way to make a living. I mean, like, you know, it is it's backbreaking work. It's done in outdoor circumstances.
It's horribly intensive.
It's physical labor. I mean, like, it's physical, physical labor. It's horrendous to do.
It's horribly insensitive of us to talk about it. But there's so much overtures toward the farmers all the time. And then, you know, there's just no improvement in what the farmer situation is. And then you have the farm bills and the, you know, to and fro that goes between them. And then almost very strange that when the farmers agitate, the same Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan is like, not today. We'll call you back.
It's a tricky thing to talk about, right? Because I understand some of the reverence towards this, right? Especially at the time when it was created, right? I mean, like, we were agrarian. We were at a time of famine, or before the Green Revolution. The Green Revolution was in progress at that point in time. Also, we were fighting wars with China and Pakistan around that time. There were a lot of this. So I understand the need for this kind of thing, but it is propaganda.
But we were not an underwear culture, you know, in the 40s, late 40s and 50s. And the farming community and the rural community was not very into underwear anyway. So when underwear culture became strong, you can see the urbanization becoming stronger. Almost, there's a huge parallel between the two. Underwear, culture, urban, all go together in one place. I'm quoting Mao, of course, now, but
sure.
May have lost something from the original Mandarin.
I think something got lost in translation there.
Google, man. Google, I tell you, this guy. Can't trust him. Yeah. Well, listen, you didn't mention. So what was the art? What was the promos that they created?
Oh, like, So it was just all like basically how UP has got corona licked. COVID. Yeah.
These figures I've seen in all English and Hindi, which are about. There's one claim where he says, they said we'll have 2 lakh cases. We don't even have 2,000. And apparently the actual truth is maybe 4 lakh.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, you're right. It's not 2 lakh. 2 lakh was the wrong figure.
Even the Modi government has been congratulating him, right? Has been congratulating Yogi government. Oh, the way they have handled the COVID, the second wave.
Yogi government's propaganda from the other government.
You send them the newsletter. You guys read this. That's it.
Don't you think, do you know how Agony Aunt columns are run? You write your own letter and you answer it yourself. You don't worry about it. Just have a normal name like Jayesh or something. Boom, who's going to argue? That's it. Done. Yeah. Anyway, let's see how it plays out. Lucky enough, it's almost like sports for me now. Politics is very interesting. People don't die. I'm okay. I enjoy it a lot. It's just when it gets
I think that's the way to look at it, right? As long as it... but again, the thing is that these things are real. And, you know, they do have effects.
Speaking of Yogi, sorry, but Trump, someone said to me Trump is very keen on coming back in 3 years.
Of course, he is.
He made some sounds last week.
He's hoping that he will have to fight Kamala Harris because they're saying that Kamala Harris has a lesser chance of winning than Joe Biden's second term.
So he's playing to his natural strengths. Racism, sexism, anti-Asianism, anti-long-hairism. Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh man, he is that's just, man, I don't even know what to say about that stuff, right? I mean, like, I can't believe that who was it?
What you should say is build a Trump Tower in Lucknow, welcome to UP, let him meet his friends, and we'll all live happily ever after.
We can get to the MS. Let's do it.
Okay, we have quite a lot of questions. Here are the MAs. The first one comes in from Gambit. He says, AMA, thoughts on King James in Space Jam 2?
I haven't seen it yet. Is it out?
Yeah, but what kind of role is it?
Michael Jordan's role from the first movie.
Yeah.
It's basically what LeBron James is doing now. But basically, I've heard is the whole movie just seems like an ad for WB. Just like all WB characters, not just the Looney Tunes. But
that's
what
the first one was.
At least restricted to the Looney Tunes.
So why
does the first one?
But what is
this one is across like DC? Okay. There are DC characters.
The characters. Why does King James have to be in the film? I mean, from his point of view, why would he do it?
Because is Michael Jordan a greater player? Who's the greatest player of all time? Michael Jordan.
He's just mimicking his whatever.
It's like Michael Jordan made a $100 million movie. I'll make a $100 million movie.
Oh, it's that. That's megalomania, bro.
Yeah, it is.
Like, yeah, I'm the greatest of all time. I'll teach Michael a lesson.
Well, he's going to become a billionaire before he's going to become a billionaire while still playing, which Michael Jordan never did.
There's too much more ways to make money in the last 10 years. And, you know, I mean, there's so many other reasons.
I agree. I don't disagree.
You devalue the dollar also, and you can't even give a proper equation.
Yeah, sure. I get that. I don't disagree with that either, right? But it's just, you know, there's...
It just sounds like a silly movie.
It's a prestige thing, man. Warner Brothers wants to remake Space Jams. Who is the best player in the NBA? The best player in the NBA, without a doubt, is LeBron James. Just the same way in the 1990s, the best player, without a doubt, was Michael Jordan.
So in Indian terms, Indian parlance, you're saying Virat Kohli should be in a remake of Shaktiman. I will not allow it. Over my dead body. I will not allow it.
Was Sachin Tendulkar in Shaktiman? Or Sunil Gavaskar in Shaktiman?
Or they weren't well at the time of shooting.
Okay.
You're at sick bay. I'm not available. Sorry. Hey, yeah. Silvery, have you seen Shaktiman?
Yeah, of course.
I think 90s. You've seen?
Yeah, I've seen Shaktiman.
You're asking in life or you're asking like regularly?
No, as a kid, I don't know. I can't remember the era. It was
90s,
if I remember right. So
it was my childhood. Still going on. Yeah.
So then in the 90s, so you were one of those kids who was forced to see it because it was just before revolution and lots of options and internet and all. And there was this,
true. I would end up watching it at these friends' place. I had these twins' friends who I would go to their place where we would watch cartoons.
Is it twin friends or twins' friends? Because a twin pair or a twins' pair? That's a big question. Where's my book?
I think a pair of twins who was a friend, who were friends of mine. Sorry. I said a pair of twins who was a friend. A pair of twins who were friends of mine.
We begin and end this show with absolute nonsense and a lack of grammatical power between three strong forces. So Shaktiman, but you know, we're making fun of our guys, but I saw Adam West and the famous Batmans of the 60s and all on YouTube going through all this. For some reason, things came up. And they're awful in terms of the body and the costume and all that, which is where we start from there only. I'm like, awful. You're not even a comedy. This is actually perfect comedy opening, you know, when a guy is badly dressed and wrong body and the wrong thing. And the pelvic area is so exposed. And I mean, it's just ridiculously stupid.
It is ridiculously stupid, but the Adam West Batman stuff was definitely comedy. It was not serious. It was camp comedy.
By the way, he committed suicide, huh? Adam West, if I remember correctly,
I remember he died, but I don't remember he committed suicide.
And such an icon for them, you know, those couple of decades of what that thing show ran. Huge name and all that.
And I mean, like, again, the thing, another thing to kind of think about, right, is also that there wasn't that much television back then. So everybody had a relationship, right?
There was television, but there were limited channels, is what you're saying.
Number of channels were limited. So even though the show...
So 5-6 shows were big, iconic shows. The rest, correct. That was it, yeah.
So,
Adam West died of leukemia, not of suicide.
I think the Robin died of suicide, maybe. The guy who played
Robin.
He's still alive. Burt Ward is the name of the actor. I thought Burt Ward was the name of the Robin character.
I thought you meant the mental
issue. No, that's Dick Grayson. After finishing.
There are many Robins.
Name of the character. He's right.
Burt Ward has never been a Robin. I mean, the character name has never been Robin. The actor was Burt Ward.
Oh, okay.
I'm looking at it right now. Yeah.
Okay.
Cool, but it does sound like both the name of the actor and the character sound sort of possible. Possibly
Ward,
superhero.
No, he's a Ward. He's a Ward of Batman. And it's not exact, you know, I mean, like the comic books like to kind of hit you over the head with what they think is subtlety. So kind of like The Week That Wasn't, right? In that sense.
Batman keeps his 15-year-old male next to him who wears underwear that's so short and so tight. And nobody says a word. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You go after all these poor guys, like, you know, all these famous actors in the Me Too scandals, like a Dustin Hoffman. And what's he done compared to Robin? Robin is, you know, for me, rather Batman. But that was terrible, really.
So this show came out in 1966. Sorry, just to come back to my point, right? Show came out in 1966, the Batman show, the one that you're talking about. I was born in the US, right? And I lived there for the first 7-8 years before I came to India. I used to see this show every day in the afternoon on television when I was a kid, right? So that was a good 10-12 years after the premiere of the TV show itself. It was on TV every day in the afternoon.
And
so
the reruns. The rerun kings as well. I've seen them in the 80s or 90s when I was in America. Old channel. Yeah.
So there you go. Exactly. So the reruns just kept coming of this, right? So it's just a...
Pow! You remember those?
Yeah. The best of it is how they climbed... the way they would shoot climbing walls was the best. Right? So basically what they would do is they'd just flip the camera and then they'd be using a rope and they'd be walking. And they would flip it back and look like they're climbing a wall. That was amazing special effects.
My kind of television. Don't work hard when you don't have to, really. Unbelievable. But it ran. You whatever you say, a whole generation or maybe two generations grew up on it. So, you know, it ran. So many people talk about him, the Marvel actors of today, you know, the bigger, older ones. They all mention him.
Yep.
You know, Avengers, Marvel, non-Marvel, DC,
this is DC, DC.
But you read both growing up. So, you know, they all mention him.
Yeah, I never read Marvel growing up in India.
Spider-Man.
I feel like, I don't
Captain
feel like...
America.
So, which was your library?
Shimaru, same as yours.
Okay.
Shimaru.
No, mine was Reader's Heaven when I was a kid. I don't feel like they had the same amount of Marvel stuff.
So, we used to have these double digests of Avengers and all these other things.
Huh.
But in Marvel, Peter Parker, Spider-Man was huge and Hulk was huge on its own. Captain America actually wasn't that big when I was growing up. He was there. Huh. We had to search for him.
Yeah.
But Hulk wasn't
Iron Man wasn't that big.
I remember Reader's Heaven a lot of Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman. I just like a ton of that. Flash. Superman,
Wonder Woman, Flash, all that, everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no, I don't remember much in the way of like Superman, Avengers, Spider-Man, Avengers, Hulk, all those.
Spider-Man stood out because he was so cocky. He was always the one that stood out. They gave a nice New York voice to Spider-Man, Stan Lee, or whoever did it in the beginning. And I think that really reverberated with everybody. If you're a young male, wherever part of the world, you like that guy. He was the loser. He was cocky, but he was always, he never won really, in his civil life. So I think that was a well etched character, Spider-Man. Yeah. Plus, you couldn't really see his genitals. So, that was a plus. Some of the other guys, they left nothing to the imagination.
Underwear outside the costume you're talking about.
What about Hulk? You tell me this guy is now 10 feet tall, but he's still got the small thing covering his, shouldn't that have grown? What kind of experiment is this?
Well, so his pants turned into shorts, man. I mean, like, what
turned into shorts, but there's no, explanation of what happens to his manhood. The Hulk, the main member of Hulk's gang. I mean, I want an explanation there. He's gone from 120 pounds to 1,000 pounds. What happens to the body parts?
That'd
be horrible if he looks down and says, "What? Same?" I mean, jeez. Back to the lab.
Okay. I think that it
you
might
never
not
thought
be...
about that as in.
I never what thought about that. But now that I'm... People? Well, I am thinking about it now, and my guess is that basically, while Hulk is in Hulk mode, the chances of him having the patience to do full proper, to have sex with somebody is unlikely, right?
But then I kid you not. Freud and Adler both mentioned that sex is a fusion of, fighting is a fusion of sex and aggression. So when he gets into fighter mode, there's sex and aggression coming out. So I'm thinking while he's punching and beating up the bad guys, he's a little aroused. that's probably why some of the guys didn't want to fight him. Mr. Hulk, not me. You win. And that's why.
That's what he means by
walls.
Smash. That's what he means by Hulk smash.
Hulk, no use hands. Smash.
Okay.
Next, what are we off?
Next one comes in from Kunal Sharma. He says, AMA for Amit. Amit, you are very knowledgeable on many topics, especially politics. Do you read a lot or do you have a related degree?
I do not have a related degree. I read a little.
I think, Kunal, please don't come on to my member of my panel like this. This is embarrassing. We're just discussing erections and some monster freakish people. And the next thing we know, this is a letter about, you're very knowledgeable on many topics. Do you like moonlight walks? I don't know what's going on. But do you read a lot is a fair point. I think it's not literally whether you read a lot, but the fact that you're always trying to garner information, which is done by reading.
Right.
So I think
that's true.
A lot of people abandon it, in our age group. Maybe Silvery is still young, but I think once you cross the 30s, a lot of people I've noticed that we've grown up with don't read at all anymore, but did read a lot up to maybe mid-30s, somewhere there. There's some point where it's falls off a little bit. One of it is the internet revolution, which causes a little bit of passive.
But I think you wind up reading on the internet too, right? I mean, like you have, if you use the right kind of tools, right? I mean, like so I have Pocket on my browser. I have Evernote on my browser, right? So whenever there's something that I want to go back and read, I mean, like I'll always save them to Pocket or Evernote and then I'll go back and read them later, right? So now, like once a week, I'll go and I'll have like 10 long form articles to read and I can knock them out in like an hour or so.
You mentioned Kindle and you're reading long form. Uh-huh. You'll be reading, you're saying the same form. I still think it's a bridge. You're the same form as you were 20 years ago.
It's not a bridge, dude. It's 100% not a bridge.
Okay, so you're using this or whatever you're using to read as against. So the reading is not suffered. Your medium has changed, but the reading has not suffered. But in most cases, it has suffered. Like, let's say my wife and me. We read a lot. We were same generation, all three of us. We all read the same 20s and 30s. We read less. Right. You've managed to, I think that's also his point, you managed to continue reading. Is that true?
I think that is true. I do think that I continue to read, but I think that a part of that is using the Kindle. But also, I think I read a lot. Like the kind of things that I read on Kindle, right? I mean, like I'll read in a year, I'll read like maybe 10 nonfiction books and I'll read like 45, like just absolutely like just pure entertainment. Like, you know, the thrillers, the fantasy, the science fiction.
But it doesn't, kind of stuff. It doesn't mean it doesn't add to your knowledge. I mean, no, but whatever the hell it is, you don't know how the knowledge comes in.
But see, Saris, the thing he's talking about, like, you know, knowledgeable on many topics, right? Which I don't think I am. But even if you were to say that I am, right? The way that comes is through internet reading, right? That comes through just like basically following stuff on the internet, searching for stuff, reading stuff on different.
It's more like fastest finger first. Now, when somebody mentions something, you Google it. We've done this in corporate events and all that. You know, people are so fast now. Trying to ask them questions and all, they're answering to the phone immediately. But then, it's cheap.
If all you're doing with the internet is to find answers out to questions, then that feels like a kind of poor use of the internet, right? I mean, like if you're reading deeper articles, right? There's some really, really amazing things that come out, right? I mean, like you read The Atlantic, you read even like, you know, the Morning Context is phenomenal, right? I mean, like as a the Stratechery, there's so many of these different newsletters, there's so many of these different kinds of articles, there's so many of these different people writing, like, you know, really long thought pieces, and these things are interesting. So I mean, I find myself interested in that.
Hello, I'm a long form reader myself. Just on Sunday I read, I think for an hour and a half, 18 ways to stimulate your pet during lockdown. And you know, and I can almost quote verbatim because it took a long time to finish. So reading is happening. It's a variety of topics.
I will just say that generally good long form articles do not take the form of listicles, i.e. 18 ways to do XYZ.
Isn't it fantastic? The moment you see a number, you know it's a complete lame brain effort.
Yeah. Right?
9 ways to screw your aunt.
Because they want you to hit next, so you see 9 ads.
No, I think it also tells your brain it's easy. You know, 9 ways. Oh, 9 ways easy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just suggest to you that let's make this fun and easy, simple, simplified for everyone.
You know what?
That you have a related degree. Answer the question.
No, I have a degree in mass communication.
Politics. In masturbation.
Mass communication.
The former would have been more impressive, but okay, mass communication.
Yeah.
Sabke paas hota hai isme kya hai. Masturbation PhD would have been, wow, Amit Doshi. I can tell you how to use both hands.
Dr. Amit Doshi.
Dr. Amit Doshi. Bringing, give peace a chance. Happy ending for my community. All in favor. Yeah. Next one.
Sorry, just before you take the next one, I found that thing which I was looking for.
Which is the movie thing?
Yeah, the yogi thing. I'll just open that up.
Are we reading it or are you telling us?
No, I'm just showing you. Like, so see, this is basically on July 13, 2021. These are all yogi articles. Chennai, Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Mumbai, Bhopal, Goa, Chandigarh, Jaipur, Kolkata. See, it's the exact same page everywhere.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Right? Yeah. And this is all the pro yogi stuff.
But Green Champion. That's the Hulk. He's taking the Hulk's title, the Green Champion, and both of them wear less clothing.
Right?
Both are not
Yogi and the Hulk. Yogi wears plenty of clothes.
He's bare chested a lot.
Is he?
Doesn't go to the same gym as the Hulk.
He does. I guess I mean, like, hey, he's got his idols too.
Yeah.
You know, the horseless man or the shirtless horsed man.
There are a few related questions to Yogi.
Yeah, he's got ideas.
Well, yes. One sec, my wife is saying bye. You guys carry on talking. I need to know where she's going. Where are you going? You're going to Colaba. You're going 1 kilometer away and you're saying bye to me. I thought she was going back to Alibaba, Hyderabad or something. Now they're all laughing. I love you. Are you going to embarrass me and come on those? But see, even that is with the mask on. This is love in the time of Avengers. Love in the time of Avengers. Wear your mask. Oh, man. If only we put the mask in the right place, you wouldn't have kids. Now I've got to find money to send one to Canada. It's amazing. Next.
There are a few questions related to Yogi. One of them comes from Anayita Pillai. She says, UP has proposed a population control bill. Individuals with more than two kids won't be able to contest elections. Ironically, as news was abuzz, with 50% of current local ministers have more than two kids anyway.
There's a very famous Hindi saying, hum do, hamare do, teesra kisi aur ko de do. So all you have to do is remove one kid or from two my, kids. To
your from Hello Friends.
Yeah, exactly.
You're
a live
from Hello Friends.
Yeah. Wow. So, it's not that. Wait, now you. Stop. It's not that I said that in Hello Friends. But you quoted me saying that in Hello Friends. That's the crime. That's the crime, my brother.
I'm just amazed right now. Cyrus pulled a quote from Hello Friends. Antariksh recognized it.
But it could be in my head because I was forced to memorize it. But I'm saying he recognized it. That's the crime. Okay, I mean, you know, you don't know what you retain. You retain what you retain. He recognizes it, which means that we touched a chord in Silvery's heart. This Harry Potter loving, you know, westernized kid, stand-up comedian, blah, blah, blue. Hello, Friends was part of his milieu growing up. He can't deny it now because he knows the quote, which will be used by UP mantris in the next forthcoming election. Oh, that's fantastic. Silvery, you stand exposure, bro. I can't save you on this one. I mean, this is really bad.
Yeah. I've seen the show. What do you got to do?
you remember the... Then you'll don't... Why do you all... You'll slam this show, but you're all quoting from it. I don't like that. That's the reverse propaganda.
See, you know the thing about The Room, the movie The Room? Like, you watch it because it's such a train wreck. Sorry, it's one of those, like, so bad that it's good, you know? So it's one of those.
Stop watching it because it was so bad, is what you're saying. And you internalize everything.
It's part of it. It's part of it. For sure.
Okay, I'll accept that. Yeah. First, I'm feeling quite, what's the word, favorable about this whole thing. I just think it's a compliment. I wish I could reach out to Ajit Pal because this is, honestly, when we do any show, when we, as you know, you're a performer yourself. If somebody quotes you or somebody, I mean, that's, because that's it. That means you really landed a punch there. There's no doubt about that. I mean, you know. The man in the third panel is always quoting people left, right, and center because they made an impression. He won't quote them otherwise. So that's fabulous. this is great. This is great stuff. But coming back to the point, all they do is offload. You guys know that famous Kushwant Singh joke, right? Mm-hmm. I love that joke. It's really silly, but I love it. So this is a stupid one where, you know, the neighbor, the one brother who comes to visit the other brother's family. Every time he finds his one more kid and in the house, so he says, Abhi, teesra bachcha kahan se aa gaya? So the brother says, upar wala ka marzi. Again, he comes back. Abhi, panchvi kid. Upar wala ka marzi. It goes on like that for a little while. And finally, you know, the brother gets angry and says, kya upar wala ka marzi? Upar wala ka marzi? Kya kar raha hai aap? He says, upar wala ka marzi? Mere bachche nahi hai. Shit, guy from the above floor. That is really bad, but it's one of my favorites. They said they're going to offload the children. See, we Indians will always find a way out of all this. I mean, these rules are of no value. Look at the way they declare wealth. I mean, I won't take names. 9 lakhs, 3 lakhs, and my wife's jewelry. I mean, the guy's son is in Harvard or Princeton. I mean, they've got bungalows everywhere. They've never paid a bill in their life, and they've got 3 lakhs. You know, I mean, what do you... Come on. And heads
some
bowed,
of the stuff is ludicrous on the face of it when you hear the income disclosures. But this is also like, you know, it's interesting how UP is going back to this idea that population control matters, right? I was reading about this when this stuff came out last week, right? UP by 2030, I think, is... Bihar is the last state in India which is going to reach replacement level population, right? Which is 2.3 children per family as an average number of this.
Above the living family.
Right. So when you get to 2.3 is when you're at the exact replacement rate. You're under 2.3, your population starts shrinking, right? So population across many states in India is already under 2.3. right? There are a few states less which are above 2.3. I think UP is kind of geared towards going below 2.3 sometime in the next 10 years. Bihar is going to be the last, which I think is 2030, 35, something like that. So overpopulation is not an issue in India anymore. It never was the issue that we thought it was once the Green Revolution occurred.
Also in America,
it's not just about the overpopulation. The fact that you have two kids and the quality of life. So you're trying to propagate that we should have better quality of life. So I have one kid or just two or not more than that. So I can make sure their quality of life is great, in not just in terms of the population expansion and what it does to the whole world.
But that's I'm guessing
it's linked to some extent.
But I'm guessing the reason the UP is doing this is population control bill. It's not increase the lifestyle benefits of people who are having kids.
It's just a populist gesture that we will reform. Yes. This kind of reform is there to make sure that, you know, people who are upright are there for you to vote for, which I think is just a waste of time in any case. Because we're going to find a way around it.
Yeah, agreed. It's a waste of time, but not only is it a waste of time, I think it's destructive, right, in some sense. Because why are you... listen, let's be very, very kind of honest about what this is, right? This is a Yogi Adityanath anti-Muslim bill. Let's be very clear about what this is.
Yeah.
There's nothing else that this is. And whether it is true or not doesn't matter in the context of this discussion, right? Because the perception is that this is true. He is putting out the perception that I am controlling those people, which is fucking bullshit, but that's what he's doing.
In America, in the other end of the world, what is happening is people like Elon Musk just came out like yesterday, I think, saying that according to him, Earth is seeing a population collapse. After a certain point, we won't be procreating as much, and the population, the world population, will actually be declining. So it he's is, like, procreate more, basically, is what he's saying.
It's a real challenge. I mean, like, we make fun of it, but it's a real problem. If you look at how the world population models are going to go 300, 400 years in the future, it's a real problem. We'll all be dead, so it doesn't matter to us. But it's a
era number, Agya. I've had two living examples of children. Never again. No mass. Roberto Duran. No mass. No mass. But you two... You can do your bit, because both of you all are childless at the moment, and propagate the species and make the world a safer place for Elon bloody Musk, who's gone off to Mars, Jupiter, and Uranus, with no syllable breaking in the last. You know, why would you name anything Uranus, honestly? I mean, for 40 years after that, the same joke is being done across cultures. Hey, have you been to Uranus? How can I go to my own anus? You know, it's a stupid conversation.
No, but it's older than a 40-year-old country name. Now, Uranus has been, I think we discovered Uranus like many, many years, much earlier.
Which is the one that got devalued? Pluto, right? I remember Pluto, we were studying. Yeah. I think we were still in school or college when it got devalued and said now it's not a planet. And then
it was much after that. It got devalued.
I
mean,
it took a long time to pass school. You know, I mean, we don't know. Who can remember? Yeah, but now they put it back as a planet, huh?
It's just weird, right? It's like this kind of more
in planet size matters.
You guys want to take a guess as to when Uranus was discovered? I just looked it up and it's very
1928.
Okay, fair. Actually, not that. You're not close at all. But Amit,
why do you say fair, you bastard? What? That's leading an old man up the.
When do you? What year do you think, or when, like ballpark figure, do you think Uranus was discovered?
Uranus, no, much older than that, man. I think Pluto was discovered in like the early 1900s, and so Uranus must be sometime in the 1800s or 1700s. I would guess.
You're right. 1700s, right? It's 1781.
There's no answer to that, because everyone finds their own anus at their own time. So in a sense, you know, I mean, I don't know if that's the right answer. So what is the actual year? 1701?
1781. It was in March 1781.
Yeah. Wow.
Wild life.
1781. Yeah. Amazing. Wow. World must have been quite a nice place then, with bloodshed everywhere, pandemics running left, right, and center. I mean, what is this pandemic compared to Spanish flu, man? It's horrible. Yeah.
We haven't discovered any planets, right?
We did, but they keep devaluing them. They got a couple of, and there should be one planet named after a Chinese guy. You think that, you know, with the contribution of Chinese history, culture, scholarship, science, technology, I mean, nothing. I mean, I don't know. As an Asian, I feel appalled. One planet should have a Chinese name. It should be like, you know, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and then it should be like Ling Chong. It should just be like that. It's just wrong. And I'm sure they have Chinese names for all of them. And so they don't accept these kind of names. Or an Indian name for that matter. Why don't we have an Indian name?
For what? We have Mangalayam. Mangalayam. Mangalayam.
Indian, it didn't go off. It didn't take off. It was a bit of a damn squib.
I mean, like, we have names, right? I mean, like, it's not like we don't have names for things, but they have Indian names. They're used in Indian languages.
Give us one. One name should be out of the 9 or 10 planets or whatever the hell they are. One should be an Indian name.
But you're talking about them in English, so they will be the English name. When you talk about them in Hindi, people say Mangal for Mars.
That's true. That's a good point. But I don't want, that's just like an almost direct translation of sorts.
Because it's the same freaking body. What else can it be but a translation?
I want the name. Why can't the name be, instead of Mangal, why can't the name be Vikas Sardesai?
But that should be the name of the planet. So it's not a translation in that sense, right? Mangal is Tuesday in Hindi or in Sanskrit.
God of war or something is involved in that, right?
No, I don't think so. You're called Manglik because it's supposed to be a bad luck thing, if I'm not mistaken. Born right. under the sign of Mars, right? But Mars is the god of war.
So there's a connection. I'm saying, why does there have to be a connection? Let's just have a name. Why can't the name of our planet be Manmohan? The one that we've chosen.
Prithvi is Earth. It does not. It has nothing to do with the word
Prithvi
Earth.
Means Earth.
No, but it means it's going to mean the same thing.
Mean the same thing. I want a name as a mark of respect to a culture.
But okay, so what does Venus? What is Venus in Hindi? I'm sure Venus means something different, right? Shukra.
Venus is German for penis.
No, Venus means Shukra. Venus is Shukra in Hindi. You're talking about the planet Shukra. But Venus is based on the goddess of love. Nothing to do with each other, unless I guess you consider Friday to be date night and you want to make that link. Wow, but otherwise...
Excellent. That's the link I wanted to make. Fair enough. Okay, let's put it out there. Those who think the names should be changed to Indian names, and I mean names, not translations or connections to a Latin name or whatever name. Indian names, like a girl you grew up with in class. Nandita, that's the planet. I want that name.
Okay.
That's what I
want. Right.
Otherwise, our culture will never go abroad. I mean,
you can name a star for like $100, right?
Really?
Yeah.
Like you can just walk into Bandra and you'll go, Shah Rukh Khan, today you're Akshay.
No, not that kind of star, like a planetary star. Like, you know, the in space.
Why are you even answering? Never answer these kind of stupid things. You know? But my part would be so much fun. Imagine if we had that power. We just walk around sets and say, what is your name? What? Amir Khan. No, nahi chalega, nahi chalega. Now your name is Pushpak. And then he has to buy it back. Oh, $100. I won't be Amir again. There's a lot of money trading hands. Hey, guys, should I buy Bitcoin?
If you're
you hesitated, gamble. That's scary. You hesitated.
You don't gamble. If you gamble,
yes. The body language is not good for me.
You should listen to an upcoming show of ours called A Show About Crypto with Rohan Joshi. And that will tell you whether you are
Rohan Joshi, the one-time comic, now financial expert.
Yes, that exactly. Yes. That's
Rohan him. Okay.
That would be him.
Okay, I'll listen to this, huh? Yes. So, Amit, you're not giving me a positive feel on this at all. So,
I bought crypto because I play poker. It's a gamble.
Everything is a gamble. Where is it not a gamble? Except mutual funds and 1.2%.
Then you should buy.
No, I'm saying it's a punt of some sort, but obviously when you live according to your means and you punt whatever you can lose.
Yeah.
Because series put some money in.
So, I would say you should buy Bitcoin and you should buy a little Ethereum and just keep it on the side.
What about some uranium and, you know, sell that to the next terrorist group that's passing through?
The Libyan
that
terrorists.
Would make you great immediate money. Yeah, that would.
Yes. Yeah. Well, there was a truck filled with that.
There was. I remember. Yeah. There was the Indian. I didn't see, but I was listening to a podcast which had a fairly like a long discussion of Back to the Future. So I had like uranium being sold to Libyan terrorists in my head.
Oh, okay.
I'm a marketing man. I think good commerce is not about judgment. Morality and judgment take a backseat to good commerce. So you sell what you have to sell. We're peddling the show for how many months now?
We've been peddling it for, it's been 6.5 months, right? Since we've been going live. And I mean, like, actually 6.5 years since we started. But
is it 6.5 years?
We started in March 2015, right? So 6 years and 4 months.
So we've been 1 year behind the BJP in terms of what we've done. Okay, fair enough.
Yeah. Yes. They came in a year. They came in a year exactly. Before we did.
May of 14, we are April of 15. Literally, if April I remember 15. Right.
Yeah, so yeah. April 15 was the launch, but we recorded in March. We started releasing episodes in April, but we started recording in March. That's the date I have as like the days we started going into studio and stuff like that.
I'll check without a bill you for conveyance. I've got it all down
okay.
in my diary.
Okay.
Bitcoin. Okay, I think we've gone way across time. People are.
I know this is the people are surprised and like, the
will
fact
you stop
is,
talking? I've got to work and things like that are coming in.
No, but you know what's amazing is that for once you didn't actually like you know you didn't try to wrap up early so that or wrap up early, like you know. In 48 minutes, otherwise you're like, okay, it's time to go, it's time to go, it's time to go.
Because I have agenda. Now I finished writing. I've been writing from 8:15. The whole Tokyo Olympics, so I don't have to read newspapers and all that, or do research. So writing went very fast today. So I'm quite relaxed now. I actually have sweet FA, my favorite part of the day starts now. My problems are walking dogs and filling diesel. Which, by the way, guys, is a story for another day. At 108 rupees in parts of India, petrol, I mean, I paid 7 rupees in 1990 or 89, 90, I can't remember the exact. For my first, you know, when I got my license, my dad sent me $50, go and get it. Was
7 rupees.
Seven liters, I got in $50, point whatever. In $50, I put 7 liters in the Maruti and came home like a proud man. And with my dad, give me the bill. He just put the bill in a bottle, you know, where all our bills were collected because for tax purposes, my dad believed, oh, bloody hell, all those bills.
I remember petrol being more than 10 rupees when I was in college.
$7 when I started, brother. I'll never forget. 108 batting today.
Oh.
So that means my father's income should have gone to match 10X. That. More than 10x. It's just, I know. I'm not complaining. Bitcoin will save us.
Bitcoin. Yeah.
Bitcoin's the
this
future,
is not
right?
This is not investment advice, huh? Just by the way, in case anybody.
No, Silvery himself said he put a lot of money in Bitcoin, and then
we are not offering investment advice to our listeners. Exactly.
No, we're not. We're talking to each other. Why should anybody else? Sorry, you're down.
Right now, I'm down. Yeah, so down. I wouldn't advise.
Initially, no. But that's the punt you take. You're taking.
Listen. Yeah. I think I've told you this, Antariksh, right? I mean, like, this is how I treat it. I did not play poker during the pandemic. I put my poker money into Bitcoin. That's it. Nothing more than that.
It has to be money you're not thinking about. Okay, you have to be able to not think about it. So again, I'm asking you, Silvery. Just I know we're running late. Did it go up when you started? It went up.
Like for a week or so, it was going up, and then suddenly the markets crashed, and then I was like, this is the worst time to get it.
I started about a year ago. Okay. Mm-hmm. I've seen a total of more than 1.5x, little less than a year ago. I've seen a total of 2.5x.
Oh, yeah.
More than double what the total amount was. And right now it's at about 85% of total invested money.
But you're still holding. You're not going to do anything.
I don't, dude. If Bitcoin is going to work, if Ethereum is going to work, then the value in this is going to be 10 years from now. It's not going to be right now. So just basically buy it, forget it.
That's what they told me about marriage.
Yeah.
Look where that leaves us now. 21 years later, she's taking my car and going to Colaba, and I can't even go anywhere. I have no work, no future, no prospects, and I'm hungry. Oh, fuck. Really. Okay, guys. So tomorrow we'll see you same time on this crappy podcast, which we rename Cyrus Says.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yep. The moment I see the name, I smile. It's beautiful. See you guys. Bye-bye.
Bye.